Shalom, praise the Lord. Welcome to a brief Bible reflection as we continue encouraging one another, still in the book of Romans chapter 8. Now looking at verse 3 and 4, where in verse number 1 and 2 we say that yes, we thank God that we are not condemned. We are no longer condemned because Jesus Christ has given us access to that position of being called partakers and heirs of the kingdom of God. He said that nobody would want to hear this statement, guilty as charged, even those who may have committed horrible, you know, things and horrible crimes. They are so much against this statement, guilty as charged. We were horrible. We had committed this great sin, but the Lord in his mercy did not declare us guilty as charged. If anything, verse number 1 says that there is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. And we said it is your choice to purpose to take refuge in Christ Jesus, who declares you free and free indeed. Because the life-giving Spirit has set us free from the sin and death. And so we are set free. Verse number 3 says, the law of Moses was unable to save us because of the weakness of our sinful nature. So God did what the law could not do. He sent his son, his own son, in a body like the bodies we sinners have. And in that body, God declared an end to sin's control over us by giving his son as a sacrifice for our sins. Verse 4, he did this so that the just requirements of the law would be fully satisfied for us who no longer follow our sinful nature, but instead follow the Spirit. Praise the Lord. We are reminding one another that we were in that doomed condition, but the Lord did not condemn us. If anything, what the law of Moses was unable to do, the Lord did by sending his own son, Jesus Christ. He sent him, and the Bible says that he put on this human body so that he may identify with us. As he sets us free, he wore the human body. And in that body, God declared an end to sin's control over us by giving his son as a sacrifice for our sins. Jesus redeemed us, having worn this body, similar body like we have today. And through that body, in that body, God declared an end to sin's control over us. The Lord is reminding us that what the law of Moses could not do, God did it. He fulfilled what was needed for us to be set free. And a very good example or a very good way to understand is the way that Lord Jesus Christ put on the human body to set us free. And the Lord through that declared an end to sin's control. This is a reminder that sin has no control over your life, because God through that body, in that body, he declared an end to sin's control over us by doing what? By giving his son as a sacrifice for our sins. And the Lord is reminding us that your freedom has not just come, you know, in that small way. It has come in a big way and in a very special way. And it, again, that the Lord has embraced us back to himself. He did this so that the just requirements of the law would be fully satisfied for us. And now we no longer follow our sinful nature, but instead follow the Spirit. And so the challenge we are setting or we are throwing to one another is this. Do you follow the sinful nature, or are you ready to follow the Spirit? The Spirit whom we said in verse number 2, that he is the life-giving Spirit. So when you follow the Spirit, you have the assurance of life. Not just life here on earth, but even life in eternity. Praise the Lord. So the Lord has done a great thing. We who are condemned, we who are lost, God did what the law of Moses could not do. Today, as we talk about the law of Moses, we are saying the things that sometimes we tend to hold on to, thinking that they can stand in the gap for us to look holy, to look acceptable, or even to please and to appease God. Nothing supersedes what God did. He sent his own Son to set us free. And the Son wore this human body. And in that body, the Lord declared freedom, and freedom indeed. The Lord bless you. God keep you. Let us walk in this freedom. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Shalom.